Good morning, students.
So today we'll study about biological classification chapter of class plus one. In the previous lecture we have read about various prominent scientists who have worked in the field of biological classification, like Aristotle, Ernst Haeckel, R.H. Whittaker, Hus. Okay, so in this lecture we will discuss about R.H. Whittaker, as his work is mentioned in our syllabus. So today we are going to discuss about R.H. Whittaker and his five kingdom classification. So as you know, what was the criteria which was accepted, which was taken into consideration by R.H. Whittaker during his biological classification for the living world? His criteria includes cell type. Cell type means whether the organism is unicellular or multicellular, means made of a single cell or multicells. Cell wall, whether cell wall is present or absent. Nutrition, whether the mode of nutrition is autotrophic, heterotrophic or saprophytic. And cellular organization means simplicity or complexity of the cellular arrangement of an individual or of an organism. So here are the criteria here is a criteria which was used by R.H. Whittaker to explain his biological classification: cell type, cell wall, mode of nutrition and cellular organization. So now it is also known as a natural classification, because his observations were quite natural as compared to the observations by Ernst Haeckel, Aristotle and other scientists. So aap jab isko dekhenge, the work of R.H. Whittaker, that how did he differentiate the living world into different kingdoms. Okay, so let's begin with, ab hum yahan se shuru karenge, yahan se upar ki or. So let's begin with complexity of cell. So on the basis of complexity of cell, means whether the cell is a single cell or multi-cell. So on the basis of complexity of cell, whether the organism is of single cell or multicell. So here you can see prokaryotic cells. Pro means primitive. Pro means primitive. और जहाँ भी शब्द आए carry, K-A-R-Y, carry means nucleus, means prokaryotic cells. So he included unicellular prokaryotic cells in the kingdom Monera. So as we have mentioned over here, prokaryotic cells and the organisms who have a single cell and they are prokaryotic were included in kingdom Monera, as they have simplest organization and of course they are of single cell. So as that complexity enhanced, means after millions of years, those single-celled organisms, they started evolving and they become multicellular after millions of years, and prokaryotes became eukaryotes, means single-celled organisms or prokaryotes, they became eukaryotes after the millions or billions of years later. Okay, so on the basis of complexity of cells, he put single-celled organisms or single-celled prokaryotic unicellular organisms in the kingdom Monera, and then he differentiated them from eukaryotic cells. तो यहाँ पे उसने eukaryotic cells को लिया और यहाँ पे इसको नीचे रखा किसको, prokaryotic cells को, ठीक है? सो इन यूकैरियोटिक कैटेगरी यहां पे उसकी दो कैटेगरीज आ रही है, एक तो वो जो कि सिंपली मल्टी सेलुलर यूकैरियोट्स थे और एक वो जो कि थे तो वो सिंगल सेल लाइक यूगुलिना लाइक पैरामीशियम लाइक प्रोटोजोम्स लाइक प्लाज्मोडियम्स अमीबा थे तो वो सिंगल सेल, लेकिन उनके जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स थे उनकी जो मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन थी उनका जो बिहेवियर था वो मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स की तरह था। तो इस वजह से उसने एक कैटेगरी वो बनाई जो कि थे तो सिंगल सेल लेकिन उनका जो बिहेवियर था उनकी जो मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन था ओके तो वो किससे मिलता जुलता था यूकैरियोट से। तो इस वजह से उसने एक और कैटेगरी बनाई कैटेगरी और किंगडम नोन एज प्रोटिस्टा एंड ही कॉल्ड them as unicellular eukaryotes. Unicellular थे तो वो सिंगल सेल, why eukaryotes? Because they do behave like eukaryotes, like Eugulina. So Eugulina in the presence of sunlight as an autotrophic behave करता है और in the absence of sunlight as an heterotroph वो as a heterotroph वो behave करता है, यानी like animal and like plant. तो दोनों की तरह वो behave करता है. है वो सिंगल सेल इसी वजह से उसको यूनिसेल्युलर यूकैरियोट्स कहा गया। एंड देन इन द सेकंड स्टेप ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स यानी यहां पे एक तो उसने प्रोटिस्टा को अलग कर दिया चाहे उसका जो प्रोटिस्टा सिंगल सेल थे लेकिन उनका जो फंक्शंस थे उनके जो बिहेवियर था वो किसके तरह था यूकैरियोट्स की तरह इसलिए उसने उनको मोनेरा से अलग करके एक प्रोटिस्टा में डाल दिया एक अलग से किंगडम उनके लिए बना दी। एंड ऑब्वियसली उसके बाद जब इसको डिफरेंशिएट किया गया हमारे पास मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स थे ही सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी आफ्टर प्रोटिस्टा देयर वर मल्टी सेलुलर यूकैरियोट्स लाइक अदर देन प्रोटिस्टा एंड मोनेरा ऑल आर मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स तो वो उसने डिफाइन किए। जब उनको डिफाइन करने की बात आई मल्टी सेलुलर यूकैरियोट्स को जब डिफाइन करने की बात आई तो सबसे बढ़िया क्राइटेरिया उसे क्या मिला उसे मिला मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन मींस हाउ डू ऑर्गेनिजम्स ड्राइव देयर फूड एंड एनर्जी कि वो कैसे फूड और एनर्जी को ड्राइव करते हैं। सो कैटेगोरिकली देयर आर आइदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स वर ऑटोट्रॉप्स सैप्रोट्रॉप्स सैप्रोफाइट्स और हेटरोट्रॉप्स या तो वो ऑटोट्रॉप्स थे जो कि अपना खाना खुद बनाते हैं बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस और दे वर सैप्रोफाइट्स मींस ऑन द डेड और डिकेइंग ऑर्गेनिक मैटर सलागड़ा जो होता है उससे अपनी फूड एनर्जी को ड्राइव करते हैं और हेटरोट्रॉप्स विच आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन ऑटोट्रॉप्स फॉर देयर फूड एंड एनर्जी। सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन आर एच विटेकर categorized multicellular eukaryotes into three different kingdoms on the basis of mode of nutrition. Autotrophs means kingdom planting. As all of you know that plants are autotrophs, they can make their food in the process of photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight. Heterotrophs is animals, kingdom Animalia, which are quietly dependent on the kingdom plants for food and energy, and of course saprophytes organisms who drive their food and energy from dead and decaying organic matter means fungi. So yahan pe usne five kingdom classification ko banaya especially on the basis of complexity of cells whether unicellular or multicellular complexity of organisms means their behavior, their and cellular organization, and of course mode of nutrition when it comes to multicellular eukaryotes. So if they were autotrophs, they were put in the kingdom planting. If they were heterotrophs, Animalia, and if they were saprophytes, fungi. Okay, fine. So next you can see here. यहाँ पे हम लोगों ने क्या किया है? We have Monera, Protista, fungi. Plantae and Animalia. So on the basis of their cell, nucleus, membrane bounded organelles, cell wall and nutrition, they are further categorized. इनके पास क्या है क्या नहीं है. So in case of when it comes to cell, so as you know, Monera includes unicellular, Protista also includes unicellular, but unicellular eukaryotes. Okay, यहाँ आप कंफ्यूज ना कीजिएगा. यूनिसेलुलर यूकैरियोट्स का मतलब ये है तो वो सिंगल सेल, लेकिन यूकैरियोट्स इसलिए बोला गया है क्योंकि उनका जो बिहेवियर है वो यूकैरियोट्स की तरह है. इसलिए फंजाई मल्टीसेलुलर, प्लांट्स मल्टीसेलुलर, एनिमल्स मल्टीसेलुलर. एंड इफ इट कम्स टू न्यूक्लियस इज एब्सेंट इन केस ऑफ मोनेरा. इज प्रिमिटिव टाइप ऑफ न्यूक्लियस. देयर इज नो डेफिनेट शेप. So, but no doubt genome or DNA is present, but in the form of, you can say, is not covered with the nuclear envelope. In protista, nucleus is present and so on, present in fungi, plantae and animalia. If it comes to membrane bonded organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, they are all absent in case of Monera. Present in protista, fungi, plantae and animalia. In case of cell wall, moneras, in case of bacteria, like in the best example of kingdom monera is bacteria. So in case of bacteria or in case of monera, cell wall is made of peptidoglycan. In case of protista, few of protistans have cell wall. In case of fungi, cell wall is made of chitin, C-H-I-T-I-N. In case of plants, made of cellulose. But in case of animals, cell wall is absent. इसको याद रखिएगा कि animal cell or animals do not have cell wall. So then nutrition. In Monera, bacteria are either autotrophs, heterotrophs, saprotrophs. So काफी wide range होती है इनके पास. ये ऑटोट्रॉप्स भी हैं, ये हेटरोट्रॉप्स भी हैं, ये सेप्रोट्रॉप्स भी, सेप्रोफाइट्स भी यहाँ पे पाए जाते हैं. सिमिलरली इन केस ऑफ प्रोटिस्टा, ऑटोट्रॉप्स, हेटरोट्रॉप्स, सेप्रोफाइट्स. फंजाई स्पेशली सेप्रोफिटिक्स, बिकॉज़ दे गेट देयर फूड एंड एनर्जी बाय डेड एंड डिकेइंग ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. सो एंड इन केस ऑफ प्लांट, एज यू नो, autotrophs, and in case of animals, heterotrophs. They are dependent on autotrophs for their food and energy. So let's come to the kingdom Monera. I am giving just introduction today, and tomorrow we will discuss about kingdom Monera. Okay. So when we study about kingdom Monera, first word comes prokaryotes, as we have discussed earlier. Pro means primitive, kary means nucleus. So, kingdom Monera is all about prokaryote or unicellular prokaryotic organisms. Having primitive nucleus, they do not have definite nucleus, or they do not have any nuclear envelope around the genome or DNA. And as you know, it's unicellular. Uni means only single cell. It has no membrane bound organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies, etc. Chloroplast, mitochondria. They do not have any membrane bound organelle like in eukaryotic cell. It has simpler structure. Of course, it is unicellular, so having very simplest structure, but a complex function. Because usko har cheez ek cell ke andar hi arrange karni padti hai. And it can be found in all possible environment, yani favorable se leke unfavorable conditions, har jagah is earth ke upar extreme conditions mein bhi ye paya jata hai. Like archaebacteria can be found in harsh conditions, jahan pe life possible bhi nahi hai wahan bhi aapko bacteria monerans milenge aapko. So in the next lecture we will discuss about kingdom Monera. Okay. About bacteria, especially bacteria means eubacteria and archaebacteria. Okay, so revise it properly. Good luck. We'll meet you. tomorrow. Thank you.